Well, it is us again, my Audio Technica AT LP120 and me. Now, this is the second video I've made of unboxing. I have gone a little deeper into the box, and here's the dust cover that sits on the turntable and should go up and down like this. But I have discovered that we are missing one little piece. Well, actually two little pieces. I first suspected something might be missing when I examined this accessory block, which has the parts for the stylus arm and the counterweight and the adapter for 45. But this box was empty, and it just happens to be the perfect shape to hold the hinges for the dust cover. And so I believe that the dust cover is here, but not the hinges. Well, I've also been dealing with the issue of how far it is from the turntable to this loudspeaker. It's about 4 feet over, and as you can see, this cord is about 3 feet long, so I may have to use this extension to go the extra distance to the loudspeakers. And fortunately, the plugs will work both on this end from the connection to the turntable. It's actually built in. I didn't plug it in down there. And then on over to the loudspeaker. And you can see this is about 6 feet, 5 feet, which will cover the distance between the turntable and the bookshelf speakers that are already up there on the mantle. I've been playing music through Bluetooth from my computer out there in the kitchen. Sometimes I bring it in here too. At any rate, I have discovered that it appears that one piece is missing. I also have in this bag the disc, which contains the program for transferring music to the from the turntable through a USB port to a computer, and so I can digitize the records. Now, I'm about, after pulling out these little cardboard stops, I'm about to lift the turntable out of the box for the first time, and you can see how beautiful it is. Underneath the turntable is the actual, oh, there's more accessories here, and it looks like here are the hinges to the dust cover. I was mistaken. They are here. They're just in a piece that I hadn't looked at yet. And so, with my mind at a little bit of more rest, I lift out the turntable, take up the power cord, move the box out of the way, set the turntable down before me, and in this second session of unboxing, I will be looking into the turntable, getting rid of some of this styrofoam stuff, and I can't tell you how happy I am that I don't have to worry about not having the hinges for this, or the dust cover. Taking the turntable out of its plastic bag, I see the tone arm is tied down from the factory. It's a little bit of styrofoam popcorn, and I walk the turntable back, plastic bag, put it in the box. Now, I have some accessories in here. Ah, yes. The platter. This, with the styrofoam hanging on it, is the platter. The round thing upon which the records are placed when we play them. I have just a little bit of a spook here how to get this cardboard off, but I don't want to just rip it because I want to be able to pack this up. In a few years, I'll be moving on. Oh dear. In a few years, I will be moving on. And I will want to just pack up this thing and take it away with me. And at the moment, I'm having a little problem removing the turntable from the plastic bag. Yes, well, that's the way the cookie crumbles. Sometimes you just have to take your time. I believe I can't do this without actually rupturing the plastic bag. That's unfortunate because I want to keep this for, like I said, for packing it up when I leave. All right. Now you can come off this way. I hope. Oh, you're still taped on over this edge, aren't you? Well, this is where the bag is going to get ruptured, I fear. Oh my. Success! I took the trashy cardboard off, but I'll have to save it. And now, I unwrap. There it is. The platter. The platter for my turntable. Now, according to the instructions, this must be set to this down here. There's a little thing that says voltage, and it must be set to match the voltage of the That set right in there. Look at that. Wasn't that nice? Wonder how it does that so easily. Just locks in place. Turn it, you can turn it, you can turn it, you can turn it. Still turn it. Now that's funny. That is quite a piece of art. So let's see. Here's the instructions. I went through already and checked for everything, but I missed these last little things where the two little hinges are there hiding in there. And it shows everything. It says tone arm assembly, voltage switch. This turntable has capacity to be used with either 115 volts or 230 volt AC power. The turntable comes shipped with voltage selector switch set for the voltage in your region. Setting the preamp selector switch. For increased flexibility of use, this turntable has an internal stereophono preamplifier. The preamplifier switch is located in the rear panel of the turntable. See figure 3, page 4. Number 29. All right, that's over here. The switch is over here in the back. Now I'm going to connect this to the bookshelf speaker, so I need to leave the switch on. If your system does not have a phono, magnetic phono input, set the preamp selector switch to line out and connect the turntable's output cables to the auxiliary or other high-level outputs in your system. When using the turntable with a computer sound card. Okay, this requires some assembly before first use. Do not connect the power. Platter and slip mat. Set the platter on. Set the slip mat on. And the mat is in here, wrapped up, more tape. I should have brought my knife so I could cut this tape. But my fingernails are growing, maybe that'll work. Yep, that did it. Well, gotta do two sides. So here we have the rubber mat for the Audio Technica, on which we will set a record. Now, I see the table underneath the disc, this does not turn, but this does. And it delivers its force, its energy, to the turntable, thusly, and it refuses to budge. I see. Loose, 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 not loose. So somewhere down there, it latches on and holds tight. Yes. And the rubber mat goes on top. Now, that is the second video of taking the turntable out of the box and putting the platter on. And before I advance to the second to connect the phone arm, the phono arm, the stylus arm, I will need to go back and study this. I've studied this all online, and I also watched many videos that vinyl people with this turntable on the internet, on YouTube and other places, putting together their turntables, as well as the Audio Technica video itself put out by the company, how to put it together. And I've read this book virtually cover to cover in an online Adobe PDF download before this turntable was even delivered. I was studying what I would have to do. But even now, as I approached the great moment when in a day or two, or if I rush myself even tonight, I may play a record, because I found some records here. They're up over there. I put them all up there, and I'm going to have to move them before I put the turntable up there. So, before I go ahead with putting together the tone arm, I'm going to study a little bit more and then make a new video. Thank you very much for watching. I'm sorry to be so long-winded, but I'm having a good time.